الله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise be to Allah, the King of the world, the Master of the Day of Judgment. I bear witness no one is worthy of worship but Allah Azza wa Jal. He didn't take a son, and he didn't take a wife. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and greatest messenger, a messenger just like his brother Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, the son of Mary, the son of Maryam. My brothers and sisters in Islam, as we are passing through the end of this year, and as the normal questions rise, and as we have to be facing the occasions of the kuffar and their so-called holidays, it's very important for us to take a look back. حينما كنا عظماء. And you will see the relationship at the end. What am I about to speak of related to these days? هذا هرقل يبعث رسالة إلى معاوية رضي الله عنه، فيقول له: علمنا ما كان بينك وبين علي بن أبي طالب من مخاصمة، وإنا لنرى أن الحق بالخلافة لك، فإن أردت أرسلنا إليك جيشا، فإن أردت أرسلنا لك جيشا يأتيك برأس برأس علي بن أبي طالب. فرد عليه معاوية رضي الله عنه فقال: أخوان تشاجرا، ما بالك أنت بينهما؟ والله لئن لم تخرس لأرسلت إليك جيشا أوله عندك وآخره عندي، يأتوني برأسك أعطيه هدية لعلي. He said, هرقل, Caesar of Rome, he sent a letter to معاوية رضي الله عنه. And he tells him, we heard about the dispute between you and Ali ibn Abi Talib, رضي الله عنه. And their dispute was not about الخلافة, as some think. Anyway, that's different time. He said, we heard, Caesar said to Muawiyah, رضي الله عنه, we heard about the dispute between you and Ali ibn Abi Talib. And we believe that you are more worthy of the Khilafah than him. And if you want, I would send you an army that will get you the head of Ali ibn Abi Talib. So Muawiyah, radiallahu anhu, send him back and he says, two brothers disputing. What's your business to stick yourself in it? And if you do not shut up, I will send you an army. It starts with you and ends at me. Jarrar. They get me your head, so I gift it to Ali ibn Abi Talib. This is when we were great. This when we were great. This is not when we have meetings behind doors with the Zionists against our brothers, whether in Europe or in Al-Haram. This is when we were great. وذكر ابن كثير رحمه الله تعالى في البداية والنهاية, his book, the beginning and the end. That in the year 187 هجر, هو رتب كتابه. The way he wrote his book, he brings you the year and whatever happened in it. Then the next year, whatever happened. So in the year 187 هجري, about 1200 years ago, he mentions that the Rum عزلوا ملكتهم كانت تدعى أوغسطا. They impeached their queen that was in charge of them. She used to be called Augusta. And they put in her place a king called نقفور. وكان شجاع. And he was a very brave man. This Augusta used to pay jizya to Harun al-Rashid, Amir al-Mu'minin. فلما أخذ نقفور الملك أرسل رسالة إلى هارون. قال من نقفور ملك الروم إلى هارون ملك العرب. إن المرأة التي كانت تحكمنا من قبل كانت تدفع إليك الجزية, وكانت قد وضعتك مكان الرخ ووضعت نفسها في مكان البيدق. And she has put you in a place of الرخ. الرخ is a huge bird, very strong bird that flies. And she put herself in a place of البيدق. البيدق is a very weak bird, doesn't even fly. You know chicken are birds, right? They don't fly. Ostrich. So she put you in a high position and she put herself in a low position. وكان حقيقا عليك أن تأتيها بالمال لا أن تأتيك هي بالمال. And the way it should have been that she should brought you, you should have brought her the jizya, you should have paid her to stay safe, not her paying you to stay safe. And I order you to come or to bring back the money that she paid you, or between me and you safe. أو بيني وبينك السيف, between you and me the sword, fight. فغضب هارون غضبا شديدا. He got so angry to the point where the people around him could not talk to him. Then he flipped the letter and he wrote on the back, من هارون الرشيد أمير المؤمنين إلى نقفور كلب الروم. لقد وصلني كتابك يا ابن الكافر. وهذه سمعتوها ابن الكافر حديثنا. لقد وصلني كتابك يا ابن الكافر والجواب ما ترى لا ما تسمع. هارون الرشيد flips the letter and he writes, from هارون الرشيد أمير المؤمنين to نقفور the dog of Rome, I have received your letter, O son of the infidel. يا ابن الكافر. The answer is what you will see, not what you hear. فجيش له جيشا عظيما. So Harun prepared a great army that وصلوا باب قلقلة. He started marching toward نقفور هذا until they passed by a city that belonged to him, to نقفور. And they conquered it and they took everything just to teach them a lesson. فلما سمع نقفور بهذا ارتعدت فرائسه. When Naqfur heard of what happened, he shook and he sent the jizya to Harun al-Rashid so he would go back and Harun accepted. This, لما كنا عظاما. This when we were great. When we were great. كانت السفن العثمانية في الخلافة العثمانية كانت السفن العثمانية إذا مرت بموانئ أوروبا تتوقف الكنائس عن قرع أجراسها خوفا من أن تستفز المسلمين فيفتح البلاد. When we were great, when the ships, the Ottoman ships, the warships, used to sail in the Mediterranean and pass by the European cities, that the churches would stop ringing their bells because they were afraid that they will aggravate and instigate the Muslims so they will conquer their land. When we were great, لما كنا عظاما. كانت أبواب الناس في الدولة العثمانية, the doors of the people, their homes, كان عليها مطرقتين أو مطرقتان صغيرة وكبيرة. فإذا طرقت الصغيرة علم أن في الباب امرأة ففتحت امرأة, وإذا طرقت الكبيرة علم أن في الباب رجل ففتح رجل. The doors of the homes in الخلافة العثمانية used to have two bells. It's like little hammers, huh? You know those bells. So when the small one small and one big. So when the small is used, that means a woman is at the door, so a woman will open for her. And when the big one is used, then it will be known a man in the door, so a woman or a man from inside will open for her. That's when we were great. مرة صلاح الدين الأيوبي رحمه الله, in the night of the battle of حطين, وهذه حطين يوم من أيام الله وستعود بإذن الله. ولو سألنا متى كانت حطين وفي أي سنة أحد يعرف. Yeah, we don't even know when it was. Even in the rounded to 100 or 200 or 300 years, no one will know. We don't know our history. كانت يوم السبت في 25 من ربيع الثاني سنة 583 من الهجرة، 4/6 جولاي 4th 1187 ميلاد 583 هجري، one of the great days of Islam. So the night before the battle with the crusades, صلاح الدين رحمه الله would pass يمشي بين الخيام بين الجند، فكان يمر على خيمة يقرأ فيها كتاب الله، ويمر على أخرى يقام فيها الليل، وعلى ثالثة فيها ذكر لله عز وجل فيقول من هنا يأتي النصر، ويمر على رابعة فيرى فيها النيام فيقول من هنا نؤتى. From here comes defeat. When we were great، لما كنا عظماء، لما كنا عظماء، عبد الله، today we have problems. What is the problem? Very simple. The problem is we became so weak and so insecure with our faith that we are arguing what's wrong with telling the kuffar Merry Christmas. What's wrong with congratulating them for their holiday? I don't blame the kuffar, I blame ourselves. We have not instilled the right conviction in our hearts. Abdullah, and I bet that everyone in this room or in this masjid, at one point in his life, had some personal issues with another Muslim to the point, Isma, to the point where the Eid will come and he would not tell him Eid Mubarak because he disconnected from him. Am I right if I say almost every one of us? Yes. That for some whatever personal reasons we stopped talking to some brothers. Business we did not agree on, whatever. He hit my kid, she hit my child, I hit their kid, whatever. So we stopped talking. Could be brothers and siblings, sisters, brothers together. Could be parents with their children. And the day of Allah comes, the Eid, and no one of the two will pick up the phone, not go, but pick up the phone to say Eid Mubarak. Right or wrong? Abdullah, this you will not give greetings for your Muslim parent because you got personal issues. In the Eid of Allah. If Allah Azza wa Jal was more important to you than yourself, then you will not allow yourself to tell someone Merry Christmas when they are celebrating the shirk, when they are celebrating that Allah has a son. Because Allah is not important, We can sit and talk all day long how much we love Allah. But in reality, how much Allah in our heart? How much Allah controls, or how much we allow the deen of Allah to control our lives? How much we truly love Allah? Abdullah, if you want to know the status, your status with Allah, people ask, how do I know if Allah loves me? How do I know if Allah pleases me? How? If you want to know your status with Allah, check the status of Allah with you. That's something you know. Something you know. يأتي رجل مثلا يقول طب هم النصارى يهنئون في أعيادنا. إيش الإشكال أن نهنئهم في أعيادنا؟ شو هو من البر والإحسان؟ وهل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان؟ He comes and he says, طب the Christians congratulate us in Eid. They don't have problem. So why we're having problem congratulating them in their Eid? Very simple answer. But لمن كان له قلب. أفنجعل المسلمين كالمجرمين؟ أفمن كان مؤمنا كمن كان فاسقا لا يستوون؟ عبد الله fasting or رمضان عيد عيد الفطر and الأضحى عيد الأضحى that comes after الحج. These rituals are nothing but establishing the توحيد of Allah. أنت when you go for حج, حج is nothing but to establish the توحيد of Allah. لبيك اللهم لبيك. So you compare someone telling you congratulations for establishing the توحيد of Allah to you telling someone congratulations for celebrating the Son of God. How can they be equal? If they're nice to us, no one tells you not to be nice to them. Abdullah, if you have a co-worker or you have a neighbor or you have a friend who's Christian, وأنت to him, you're so nice and you're so kind the whole year. And comes their holiday, Christmas or whatever. And you choose, because of your religious conviction, not to tell him happy or Merry Christmas. So he decides to be angry with you. After being good to him the whole year. And now you tell him it's religious reason and he gets angry. Is such person worth to be friend with or to care about his feelings? And don't tell me I'm making da'wah here. لا يطاع الله إلا بما يرضي. Allah can only be obeyed with what's pleasing to him, not to your mind. Abdullah, Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran that the heavens and the earth and the mountains shake and about to be destroyed, to crumble. From that they claim Allah has a son. And you tell them happy Merry Christmas. Or someone will say, well, it's not religious anymore to them. It's cultural. Really? Really? Who are you for? Yourself. One of the parts of their celebration is to be in the church. And the Catholics go to the church at midnight. So it's not for each other. At a Santa, you guys met Santa? At a after, called after Saint Nicholas, as they call saints. He was one of the people who signed the agreement in year 300 something, 330 or something, Miladi, that Jesus is God. And the Trinity was introduced into the religion. And he was one of the establisher and founder of that conviction or that creed. Before that, there was no such thing in Christianity. He was one of the people who introduced Trinity and Jesus is God. And our children ask, where is Santa? We need to go back when we were great to see the honor they had. Abdullah, you can't lock your phone if you're weak. You can't turn off your phone and stay home and not interact with anyone for one day so you don't have to say Merry Christmas if you do not dare to tell them right in their faces, it's against my religion. You can't sacrifice a day for Allah. Where is our conviction? Most probably some of us sitting here and say, what is he talking about? Wars in the Muslim land and Muslims being killed and this guy talking about Americans. Abdullah, this is Al-Khalid. This is where the problems are. We have no conviction of what we believe. We're Muslims, but we don't trust Islam. We Muslims, what we don't believe it's the right way. We're Muslims, and even if we believe the right way, we don't want to follow. We deserve what happens to us. قل هو من عند أنفسكم. قلتم أن هذا. قل هو من عند أنفسكم. Allah says. ولما أصابتكم مصيبة قد أصبتم مثليها قلتم أن هذا. قل هو من عند أنفسكم. It's from your own hands. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Because of what our hands have committed. If we cannot stand firm and strong to utter our conviction and say it's against my religion, for something like that, he's not holding a weapon to your head that if you don't tell me Merry Christmas, I'm going to shoot you. No one does that. Even most of them will not even care. And he will respect you. He will respect you. As long as our main concern to please him and forget about him, we're gonna be down there. وطن نفسك. Train yourself. Tame yourself. علي نفسك. Wants to take you down. Why you have a problem with that? Stand up firm. If you cannot stand up firm, and the one in front of you is without weapon, you want to tell me you can't stand firm when someone holding a weapon? Give me a break. Give me a break. Abdullah, the Deen of Islam, came to give you honor, to give you individuality, to make you different. Because you are the carrier of La ilaha illallah. Not suddenly, mashallah, the brother becomes da'iyah. Christmas Eve. Brother, why you're going to the Christmas party? Make da'wah. Yes, Allah. Make da'wah Christmas Eve. Anta, you need to be careful driving on the roads on Christmas Eve. When I make da'wah, you left the whole year, make da'wah on Christmas Eve. Taqillah. Who you for? Abdullah, how if Allah Azza wa Jal take your soul that night in that place? How are you going to face Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Let's be confident of who we are. Let's give ourselves and reclaim our identity. هويتنا هي عزنا. نحن قوم أعزنا الله بالإسلام. We're people honored with Islam. Nothing else. Nothing else. So when we give up that, give up everything. نسأل الله أن يثبت قلوبنا على ما يرضي. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم يا جميع المستغفرين. استغفر الله. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. وأصلي وأسلم على خير هذا المبعوث رحمة للعالمين محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Just very small question. If you were not here last week, raise your hand. Hi. Gonna get a gift, John? يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, sponsored by Best of Business, the gift. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. He says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet of Islam, that no one amongst you will truly believe. يعني will not fulfill the faith the way you should unless you fulfill certain conditions. One of those conditions is to love for your brother what you love for yourself. And there is nothing better to love for your brother that we would love for yourself than to see him on ta'a, to see him doing something good, obeying Allah. Do you agree? Can I love, always we our mind goes to money. Huh? Do I love for him money the way I love for myself? There is more important things. Money is not bad, but there are more important things. That I love to see him obeying Allah. I see it. That's where joining good and forbidding evil comes in. Into why Allah makes us the best nation with this condition to join good and forbid evil. Because when you join good, you are happy when you see Allah being obeyed. And you are depressed when you see Allah being disobeyed. That's true faith. True faith. Tahzan. And you feel saddened, and you feel the grief and asa and harm in your or hurt in your heart, just when you see people disobeying Allah, because you care so much about Allah, you don't like people to see. You don't like to see people disobeying Him. This is faith. This is faith. So the Prophet ﷺ said, you will not truly believe, you will not reach that level of faith that I want from you until you or unless you love for your brother what you love for yourself. And as we have established that, the best thing you can love for your brother, that you will love for yourself, is obedience. With that said, as you know, last week we did a fundraising for the message. So if you weren't here, we like to give you the opportunity because we like for you to obey Allah the way we, some brothers here obeyed Allah last week by giving. And as you know, this masjid is being established and still trying to get on its own feet. So the brothers who raised their hands, inshallah you get a gift from Allah. By donating. So inshallah, there will be a couple of forms. We expect you inshallah to fill out before you leave. And we mentioned last week that for us to get the final CO, we need to do some major work on the second and third floor. which will be inshallah the future full-time school where all of us will benefit from, especially our children. So be part of this and put and be part of the legacy and sadaqa jariya for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And also the end of the year, this is the last Friday of the year, so as you know, whatever you give could be tax deductible. And we are a non-profit organization. We can give you a receipt, so you can claim it on your taxes. I mean, you can donate $50,000-$60,000. That will drop your bracket, you know, your tax bracket. And that should save a lot of money, inshallah. But let's be generous. And there is no harm to compete again. You gave last week, to give again. No harm with that, nothing wrong with that. Until you are putting it in the hand of Allah. And that is what you will find for yourself later on in your account. So inshallah, the brothers will be holding the form. Be generous. I will not stand here and do a fundraising and ask who can I give. It's you guys in this community, in this masjid specifically, have proved that you don't need that to be done, to give. Wallah. And I say it, not because I want you to feel good about yourself. I'm saying because I truly believe it. This community is special because we don't need to push you to give. We ask you give. When you are being asked, you stand and you fill the space. And I know, brother, last week he gave $1,000. He tells me, wallahi, this is the only $1,000 I have. And I believe. He gave all his wealth. To compete. And this is what we find. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها يا رب العالمين اللهم ردنا إلى ديننا ردا جميلا اللهم ردنا إلى ديننا ردا جميلا اللهم أصلح رجال المسلمين اللهم أصلح نساء المسلمين اللهم أصلح أبناء المسلمين اللهم أصلح بنات المسلمين اللهم أصلحنا أجمعين يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير اللهم اجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر اللهم فك أسر المأسورين اللهم فك أسر المأسورين اللهم فك أسر المأسورين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. And the last word I would say, I'm really very happy today because I see very young brothers here. And this is what really built in women, the youth. And I see many. I know it's on. And I know schools are off. But I tell you, the youth, that this ummah needs you. And it's not enough that you only come when school is off. It's not enough that you only come to the house of Allah when school is off. You push your parents, and you talk to your teachers, and you talk to your peers in school, that I need to go to pray every Jum'ah. And I'm talking directly to the youth. To the youth. Do not let anyone stop you from coming to the house of Allah. No school is worth to disconnect from Allah Azza wa Jal the whole year and just come for a couple of Jum'ahs. Allah, when there is school, is the same Allah when their school is off. Be a man. Speak out your mind. Talk to your parents. Talk to your teachers. And arrange to you and talk to the youth. And I hope our parents can be understanding.